If you want to use the text that you match using a regular expression, the best thing to use is re.findall. This video is part of a series on Python regular expressions in simple English. re.findall. In this video, we're going to look how to match patterns at the beginning and at the end of a line. We're going to look how to use the escape character and also look at how to use brackets. We're also going to finish off the quantifiers. In the second half of this video, we've got a challenge for you. We're going to use some sample text you can see here. That's a list of names and some scores. The code that we used in the first video was re.search. Here's an example. So we had the regular expression inside an if statement. So in an example here where we matched the digits, you can see the numbers in red that would be matched with that regular expression. Search checks to see if the pattern exists. Findall is different. We actually extract the text that we find. So here we're going to try to find the numbers and then print what we find. So if we look at the text and find the same digits, but the output is different. It's not a yes or no. Here we used a for loop and looked in each line, and now we can see that we've actually got each digit inside a list. That example, we looked at each line. Now you might want to use the whole text. So in this code, we put all the lines together and then we look for, we have all the digits inside one list. So there are several ways you can use this code. In this video, we're going to look at how to match patterns inside each line, so inside a for loop. So if you slightly change the code, so the regular expression includes the slash d for digit and plus for one or more, you want to match numbers together. So you can see we still match the same digits, but the output we have, instead of individual digits, we have numbers like 89 and 21 and 66. To simplify the code, we can take the pattern and put it in a variable. So here, if you look at the code, we've got the same pattern, but we've called it pattern as a variable, and we put it in the re.findall statement. That's one way to make the code a bit easier to understand. Now we've been introduced to re.findall, we can continue looking at different regular expressions used within Python. Using the same code, we're going to look at different patterns. To start off with, we're going to look at anchors. First anchor is this character that means start with. So our pattern starts with a dot, which matches any character. So this pattern will match the first character in each line. So we look at our text and you can see the first character is the first digit in each line. We look at our output, you can see we have the digits 1, 2, 5, 9, 1, 1, 1, 2. The other anchor matches the last characters and we use the dollar sign. In this example, we're using a dot again, so we're going to match the last character, whatever character it is. If we look at our text, that matches the last digit in most of the lines, except for the Amy Wong text, which has a colon as the last character. So if we look at our output, we see the numbers and the colon. Previously, we just matched a digit at the beginning, but in fact, we've got numbers that are more than one digit. Now if we want to match the dot that's after those numbers, we can't use the dot in the regular expression, because that matches any character. So what do we do? What we do is we use the escape character. So you can see here we're going to begin the pattern, starts with the caret to say we're going to begin the line, match at the beginning, slash d plus means one or more digits, and then this slash dot means we actually want to match the character dot. So if we look at the red match characters in our text, you can see we've got the numbers, so match with the slash d plus, but also the dots are coloured red as matched. So if we look at our output, we have the numbers and the dot in our output. We've extracted all of those characters. Now if we don't want that dot, we can use brackets to say we want to extract just what's inside the brackets. So we've got the slash d plus means the digits, and we want to match the dot, but we don't want it in our results. We're going to look at another example of the escape character. Here we've got some text that uses the dollar sign, so we want to match the actual character of the dollar sign. So we use the dollar sign with the escape character and then the slash d plus to match the digits to zero. So you can see our output, we have the dollar sign 20. Again, we can use brackets. So if we don't actually want the dollar sign in our output, we can surround the digits, the slash d plus, with the brackets, and therefore our output now is just a 20 by itself. Finally, we've got to look at quantifiers. Now, we've looked at these before, so here we're going to look at the differences to the plus and asterisk and question mark. So here's an example where we've got a series of numbers with one and zeros. So 1, 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, a million. So it's basically 1 followed by some zeros. So if we find a pattern 1, then a 0 1 or more times, that's going to find 10, 100, 1,000, 100,000, a million. So that's going to find all of them except for the first one, because we need to have a 0. So that's the plus quantifier, which means one or more. Now the asterisk, the star, is different. You don't have to match 1, it matches 0 or more. So this is going to match the same, but also it's going to match 1, because the pattern is 1 matches 0 if it's there, but if it's not there, it's okay, you can still match. So that's the difference between the plus and the star, the asterisk. The plus needs 1, 0 to be there to be matched. The question mark matches 0 or 1, so 1 by itself matches because 0 doesn't need to be there. 1, 0 matches because 0 is there. And in the other examples, it only matches the 0 once. So we have 1, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, because we're matching 0 or 1 times. So that's the difference between the plus, the asterisk, and question mark. Now we also use the plus and question mark together, and that makes the plus not greedy. So instead of matching as many zeros as it can, as it did before, if you put a question mark after the plus, it just matches the first occurrence. So this just matches 1, 0 in the 6 times it's possible. With the asterisk, it also matches not as much as it can, but as least as it can. So in this example, it just matches the 1 because we don't need the 0. So that's the difference between the plus, the asterisk, plus the question mark, and the asterisk and the question mark. Again, if we look to see if something is greedy or not, here we have dot plus going up to an O. So if we look at this text, we're going to find the last O and match all the way up to it. So it's greedy. If we put a question mark in there, instead of matching up to the last O being greedy, it matches up to the first O. So the question mark makes a big difference to the plus or the asterisk. It stops it from being greedy. Okay, we've got a challenge coming up, but first we want to see how we can remove HTML tags. So here's an example of a web page with the code that you don't normally see visible. So this code is these HTML tags. So you might want to get rid of these if you're parsing this text, and you can do that using findall. So this web page would look like this in your browser. So there's some text here, it's quite a simple web page. So if we look at the code, we import re. In this example, we saved the web page and we're just going to open it, and we're going to put all the text together, and then we use this quite complex regular expression in a re.findall, and then we can print a result as a list. We can print each element in a list. So when we print that, you'll see this output. There's a couple of empty lines that I've made quite a little bit smaller, but basically this is the output, which is the text you see in your browser. So let's have a look at that regular expression. So here's a regular expression at the top, and I split it into three parts so I can explain it. The first part matches the first HTML tag, which is this angle bracket, which looks like a less than, and another angle bracket that looks like a greater than sign, and a dot star question mark matches everything in between. So that's the start HTML tag. The number 3 shows us the HTML end tag, which is the same except for it has this slash after the less than, which signifies it's an end tag rather than a start tag. So we've matched the start and end tags, so we want to extract the text in between. We can do this in several ways. Well, first of all, we're going to use the brackets to say this is what we want to take out. And in this method, we're going to say we want to match everything up to the first angle bracket, the first character in the end tag. So this less than sign, we use the escape character before it, we're going to match everything. It's not that, one or more times. So basically that matches everything from the start tag to the beginning of the end tag. Now if you want to get the text straight from the web, you can use several things. This is the code we've got from just a website, and that just prints the text. If you extract it, then the list that you extract is quite big, over 600 elements. So be careful when you do use regular expressions to extract web text. It's quite complicated. Web pages are complicated. There are many links and different languages available and scripting languages, so you get a lot of empty elements in your list. If you extract a web page, you assume there's a normal start and end tag. And that's not necessarily the case. So there are Python libraries that parse web text for you rather than you having to write a regular expression. So maybe having a look at something like Beautiful Soup. So if that's what you like to do, good luck with that. Okay, now time for the challenge. We want you to extract all the names and the scores from our sample text. So here's the text. How are we going to get those names and those scores? So pause the video, have a go, try it, and come back and check your answer. Okay, now for the answer to the challenge. Let's go through the stages needed to make the regular expression. So the names are between the dots after the numbers and the colon, so we can parse the text in between with the dot plus regular expression. So here we've got slash dot to match the actual dot, then match everything up to a colon. So we start with that, and that will match the dot, the space, the names, and the colon. So that's what we start off with. Here's the output. Now we don't want the dot and we don't want the colon, so we can use brackets here. So now we've got the names with a space in front of them. So we can remove that space. We take, like, we can use the slash s for space and put it outside the brackets. So now in our list we have the names. So now for the scores. So if we use another dot plus after the colon, let's see what that matches. Well, it matches the scores, but it also matches quite a lot of space as well. So let's have a look. If we use the slash s plus, that will match all the space and use the brackets again to say we want the text after the space. So we've got two brackets here. So inside our list we've kind of got a tuple, which means we've got two things, or multiple things, in this case two, and here we've got the name and the score. And this is nearly what we wanted. But in the middle we've got Amy Wong, who hasn't got a score. So we might want to actually extract the name even though there's not a score there. So how would we do that? Well, the pattern that we had before used the plus. If we use the star, the asterisk, it matches, but it also matches if it's not there. So it matches if it exists. So here we have the names and the scores, but also for Amy Wong we have the name and we match where the score would be, if you like. There's no score, but we have all the names and all the scores. Now that's correct. If you want to be very precise, we can look at the name Stewie and there's a space in between the name and the colon. So how would we get rid of that if we wanted to? So here we can put a slash s star in. So if there's a space, we match in. If there's not, it doesn't matter. So that will take that space away from the name. So we finish with the extracted text, which was the challenge of matching the names and the scores. Well, that was quite complex, but if you managed to do it, congratulations. So I hope you understood the find all regular expression using Python, re.findall. If you wish to ask any questions, please put them in the comments and we'll try to answer them, or even put the answer in the video. If you haven't already, please subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you for the next video.